Hello, and welcome to my report for April's astrology for May 28th, 2014. And I'm April. And today is the new moon in Gemini at 7 degrees. And I have a special going on right now for the next 48 hours only. And that is can be found at aprilsastrology.com on my page for readings. So once you're done with this video, go ahead and check that out, and we'll get a reading done for you. So, new moon in Gemini today at 2:40. Let me just double check that. 2:40 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And Gemini is the planet of communication. And Gemini is the planet of the twins, dark and light, above and below, within and so without. You know, Gemini is those dualities. It's an air sign, and so it's an intellectual and mentally oriented sign. Now, Gemini, this Gemini new moon, is in a square aspect with Neptune, who is the antithesis of reason and intellect and the mental realms. He is water. He is the sea. He is the ocean. He is the earth shaker. He is all about feeling and flow and spirit, and that which you can't see or feel or touch or taste. He is romance, and he is passion, and he is he puts a soft glow on everything he touches. And so it's in a square with this sun and the moon. The sun and the moon, the new moon, means that the sun and the moon are conjunct. That means they're together. So the masculine and the feminine are in a state of union always during the new moon. They're in opposite at the full. And it's in Gemini. So it's about the merging of the masculine and the feminine as well. Squaring Neptune, though, we have a very nebulous and maybe confusing, maybe delusional kind of situation. Very difficult, perhaps, to make decisions in this moment of this new moon. And that's okay. It may be that this is not the moment to do that, to make decisions. It could be that this is the moment to communicate, Gemini, with Spirit, Neptune. Now, because it's a square, squares are tension. They, when they show up, that means that there are energies that are just not jiving with one another in a way that is easy. That friction is also what creates excitement and pearls. I mean, like that it's the irritation of the oyster that creates the pearl. So we have this opportunity to create a pearl right now, but we're having to tune into spirit and to hear not only, you know, Gemini can have a tendency to get very nervous and want to talk and try to, you know, talk its way through everything and rationalize. And so Neptune is saying to listen, to pause and to not only speak, but to listen. There may be, and we all do this, there's not a soul out there, I think, or maybe there are some enlightened folks, but most of us are self-deceptive in some way and rationalize. This new moon is an opportunity to release those rationalizations that we might be having. So Gemini's kind of like, he's a trickster. He's ruled by Mercury. Mercury's the trickster. He's one of the only entities that can go to the above world, the middle world, and the below world, and just and travel up and down. And he transmits messages. And he transmits. He's a guide. He's a psychopomp. He's a shaman. He sort of rules shamans. Crossroads. Thieves, though, too. So we have this magical liminal space that this new moon puts us into. And new moons are the doorway into the lunar cycle for the month. So not only is this for today, this new moon, but it goes through the next month. So we're dealing with, through the month, some of the places that, we might have been sold, either sold it to ourselves or been sold by somebody else, something that's not quite on. The sales guy who shows up with the, hey, you want to buy a new car? You want to buy, I got a car right here. I got a vacuum. It'll work like magic. You've never dealt with a vacuum like this. It can, you know what I mean? Like, there's that guy who shows up and knocks at the door, and you buy, you're just like, why did I buy this? What was I doing? Because if you have been sold something, or if you have bought something, or if you have, you're susceptible, or we get susceptible to that kind of, we get susceptible to packaging and sensationalism and advertising and things like that, because there's a dream within ourselves that may be unlived or even unrecognized. And there are those energies out there that can find the hook and get us to give something for something that isn't really substantial for us and isn't really correct for us. Sometimes we can get hooked because we think that there's a should that we have attached to a value that isn't really ours. So perhaps we feel that logically this is the next step I need to take in my career, for instance. Or logically this person looks really good, or it all fits together really well the way that I have this. But now we've got it with this new moon, we've got to get into, like, does it feel right? Does it smell right? Something can be packaged beautifully, and if it smells bad, it's not correct. Does it sit right in our bodies? So there may be some moments, especially today, the day of the new moon, but over the course of the month, where we become aware of some places where maybe there have been some dreams that were wonderful and things that looked fantastic. I think of the Seven of Cups in the tarot with all the cups with all the shiny stuff, and we're like candy store. You know, there may be some things that we've been wanting, or there may be some dreams that we've chased, that this new moon is kind of a wake-up call that we've grown out of them, because we mature and we change and we develop. And so things that were once really juicy might not be so juicy now. That's okay. And then also, we're getting, because it's squaring Neptune, because there's this communication between this new moon and Neptune, there's a lot of signs right now. So things that just aren't, like, working the way that they used to, or you're getting messages. I mean, it could be literal emails or letters in the mail. I got a few of those today where I was like, okay, you know, maybe I need to change my course a little bit. Maybe this road instead of that one now, or step up my game in this way. But there's ways in which, we may not have been, things may not have been working the way that they used to. So now or just never did. We just, framed it a certain way again, and now it's not correct. So just recognizing if that's so. And then the next step is to tune in and to hear and to perceive and take some quiet moments, especially today, but throughout this week and the month. take some moments of quiet curiosity, where we just sort of maybe just take some breaths in and listen with a curious mind to what the messages are, and get guidance in that way. So we're going to have a shift tonight that I think is going to help with this cycle, and that is that Venus is moving into Taurus. So she's moving out of Aries, which is Mars' sign, which is very fiery. That's what, you know, I've said earlier, if you've watched my reports earlier, she's in her red dress driving a race car, and she's got her, like, red nails. You know, like, now she's moving into her home sign of Taurus. So this shifts our heart energies into a place of physicality and the body, and this is going to help us ground. So the new moon, with all of its infinite possibilities, you know, both Gemini and Neptune love infinite possibilities, you know, and not having to make decisions, and they hate being grounded because don't pin the butterfly down, you know. And they're both, one's air, one's water, you can't really grab them. It's this sort of, this energy that's not very conducive to manifestation, really. It's still in these realms of dream and idea. Venus moving into Taurus now takes this energy and grounds it. So we want to be clear to set our intentions today. Be tuning in, be listening, be aware of any sort of places where we might, you know, be susceptible to packaging or to slick advertising, whatever that, however that manifests, you know, real advertising on television or somebody's bullshit, you know. And moving it into the body. The body, moving our awareness into the body, because the body never lies. It never lies. You can talk yourself into anything. We can rationalize anything, you know. You can frame it and, you know, when you get the oogs in your stomach, you know, you get those in the solar plexus when somebody walks in the room, and you think, well, they look good, they dress nicely, they speak well, they're a friend of so-and-so. Well, this person recommended, but you've still got that feeling. That feeling doesn't lie. There's something that's not correct. So this is part of how the body guides us. Also pleasure. If we feel pleasure around someone. I have nothing in common with this person, but I certainly enjoy their company. I don't know why. Well, this is telling you something as well. What are our bodies drawn to? Not just sexual desire, but also just what, when we're around this thing or we're doing that thing, is our posture better? Do we feel better? Do we have more vitality? What brings that kind of physical vitality into our lives? And what do we value? What matters? The word matter is all about Taurus, the mother, Mother Earth, the ground, the earth, matter, substance. What matters right now? This is another thing this week that we become more conscious of as Venus moves into Taurus and stays there for a little while. The body, taking care of the body. Is there anywhere we have tight muscles perpetually? Tune into that place. See, ask, you know, Gemini new moon. Ask those muscles. Why are you tight? What are you telling me? Where am I holding energy? Where am I not allowing energy to flow? Does my body not have pain? Where do I feel really good? Where do I not feel anything at all? I mean, that's another indication. Every place in our body is symbolic of a part of our lives. So I don't have time in this video to go through all of that kind of stuff. You know, the chakra system and the palms. And I mean, you can anywhere you have something going on, For instance, the neck is ruled by Taurus. We can at least say that. And with Venus moving into Taurus. So this is the throat chakra. This is the truth. What matters? The voice. A lot of Taurus people actually are good with their voices and their words, like Shakespeare was a Taurus. A lot of Taurus singers. A lot of Taurus dancers, actually. The art, Venus is the arts. The art through the body, which is Taurus. Dance as an art form is a, you know, using the body to make art, using the body as one's instrument. And the voice, singing and all of that. So what makes us sing? What makes us want to dance? If we're not dancing, why not? If we are dancing, wonderful. Maybe bringing some more yoga and stretching into our lives. I just took a plane from Rome, and I'm a dancer, and that's one of the reasons I was in Rome, was to perform and to teach dance. I am a Taurus sun sign, and so I'm a dancer, and I sing as well. And I was there for dance, and on the plane, every so often I get up and I stretch and I do some yoga stretches. You know, nothing incredibly dramatic, but, you know, some basic stretches so that my body stays healthy and so that my, you know, spinal discs don't contract and so that my shoulders and neck are healthy. I have some things. So, and people question this as though this is very strange. And of course, it was wonderful because I saw another man doing downward dog on the other side of the plane. I'm thinking, consciousness expansion. Let you know, good. There's more people doing this. That's good because this is ridiculous that we think that this is normal and okay to sit and compact our lower backs and spine and our discs like that for hours and hours. And this is supposed to be okay. It should be the norm that we get up and stretch our bodies and make sure that we're eating properly and regularly and are hydrated and, you know, all of this. So that is the unusual thing. And, you know, comments, oh, are you doing your stretches? You know, like I was a funny person. I of course don't care. I do it all the time anyway, but, excuse me. The point being that, the Venus into Taurus makes us more aware of that. And the beauty of the body, our bodies are incredible and beautiful. The way that the muscles adhere to the bones and the joints and the whole nervous system. And what an incredible gift this is. What a miracle our bodies are to have. And so becoming aware of that and the energies that move through our bodies at this time. And also simple things like gardening, making a meal, cooking, taking walks out in nature, you know, as though nature is separate. We are nature. So becoming aware that we are nature, that's another part of the consciousness that we are growing this week and this month, as Mercury also moves into Cancer, which is another mother sign, Cancer. It rules the home, and it rules the emotions, and it rules conservation, and history and memory. So I'm thinking with Venus and Taurus and Mercury moving into Cancer, we've got a focus on the role of nature and our relationships to the creatures of the earth that are not human, our dogs and cats, but also so-called wild animals. You know, I think of, you know, any... making a relationship and becoming aware and valuing our relationship with all of creation, and a mind, Mercury, for conserving that's out there and keeping that preserved and conserved. And then also Taurus and Cancer, Venus in Taurus, Mercury in Cancer, we're in some territory with those two signs that make us more aware of home life. What does home mean to us now? What are we comfortable at home? Do we have a home that reflects our values? Do we have people in that home that reflect our true values? Are we able to communicate, Mercury, our emotions, Cancer, with clarity and with safety? because cancer rules safety and security, to the people that we have in our lives? Are we able to share our hearts of hearts? This is really important. If you can't do that at home, where can you do that? So becoming aware of that as well. And so also cultural preservation. So the conservation of nature, but also cultural preservation, a consciousness around protecting historical landmarks and places that have history. Our American culture in particular is very concerned with newness and growth and so-called progress. And it's important for us to balance preserving these wonderful places, both in nature and in history, human history, and the history of our communities. So Mercury also goes retrograde. I'm looking down because I'm looking at the exact date so that I can tell you when Mercury goes retrograde. It's not during the time of this week's report, but it will go retrograde on the 7th. And this means that we're in the shadow period of Mercury. And so that's tricky business. So now we're getting to where, I know, Mercury retrograde is like infamous and everybody blames, this went wrong, it's Mercury retrograde. No, it means that it's time to go inside more and to become, go with our intuition on things. So it's an introverted Mercury. And our, again, you know, I don't mean to like be a jerk about our culture. You know, there's some wonderful aspects and there's some not so wonderful aspects. And I become aware of these things as I was just in Rome. You know, I travel a lot and I become aware of, as I travel, the positive and the negative aspects of all the places, including my own home here in the United States. And we've got a lot going for us as far as innovation and newness and a positive attitude towards trying new things. What we don't have quite as much is we don't value introversion and history and what we've traditioned quite as much. So, but particularly, you know, we have our traditions, but introversion I'm a natural introvert, for instance, so my point of reference for my life and my orientation is more toward my inner world than it is toward the external world and the social world. And we need people like us introverts. We're the artists, we're the astrologers, we're the people who interpret the stars and the energies and the emotions and the inner, the archetypes, and we're the people who do that, and that's some important work to do. So Mercury retrograde puts us collectively in a mind where we're able to go inside, and this can be stressful for some of us who want to see external developments all the time. But again, the tree can't grow up very high if it doesn't have good roots that reach deep into the ground. So Venus moving into Taurus, Mercury moving into Cancer, these are feminine signs. These are receptive signs. Mercury's getting prepared to retrograde. Again, this is receptive. This is pulling back. There's a lot happening in that respect. So I think that we're entering a phase now where we're going to start to ground a lot of the ways that our lives have changed and feel out what's really of value to us, what we truly desire. That's Venus in Taurus. And value our emotional selves and our bodies even more than we have been, maybe, perhaps. And use our bodies to connect to spirit. Because I think of Eckhart Tolle. He's one of my favorite people in the world. And he talks about the body and the presence, being present with your body and just breathing. and tuning into your body as the gateway into presence. And when you're present, when you're really in the present moment, that's when you start having new thoughts. Instead of circling around in the same thoughts that we have, we sort of get caught up in thought. Thought is a tool. It's not the thing itself. Thought is part of a process that we're supposed to be using to access our intelligence. It's not intelligence itself. And so the more that we're able to be with our bodies as this gateway to the eternal self, the more life can flow, which is this Neptune presence, an element of this lunar cycle, and the more we actually get real answers to some of the questions that we have. So with that, this report is complete. Again, please check out my website at aprilsastrology.com for a reading for yourself. These energies that I talk about, they're collective, and they're things that we all we're all going through and that we're all affected by, but all of these energies, these planets, Mercury, Neptune, all these things that I'm talking about, they're actually making angles and they're transiting and they're traveling through parts of our charts that are specific just for us. So they affect us, each person, very differently. And the only way to know how that's going, like this new moon, what house did it fall in your chart? That helps us understand exactly how it's going to affect us individually. So you find that out through a chart reading. So again, aprilsastrology.com. I hope to talk with you. And thank you so much for watching this report. And take care and have a wonderful week.